guys are live.
Coming up on this Wednesday night edition of UATV.
UATV has come a long way since its inception.
When we went on the air in the fall of 1996 as UATV, we had a couple of machines in that room back over there. We had a program that we would produce once a week called Arkansas on Campus, and a program that we produced like quarterly called On the Hill. And I had some other things that I had done.
The main thing was to get something on the air and have it be something regular that the students could actually go on the air. In other words, have a television station.
Coming up, a contamination problem and some campus vandals. Join us next.
In its earliest days, UATV was largely confined to class-produced programming, but it was Professor Larry Foley's goal from the very beginning to have a student-run TV station. The germ of this idea came from his own experience as a student at the U of A working for the student-run radio station.
So it was a little radio station, and it was literally the inmates running the asylum. But we loved it. I loved it. I fell in love with broadcast journalism at the old KUAF, and so really that was kind of my model. Than thinking that we needed something like that in television for the students to run.
When I came in, it was essentially me trying to get this started and some eager students who would work along with me, but nobody really knew exactly how we were going to pull it all off. And the key now is that students have created their own content.
From the campus of the University of Arkansas, a UATV production. In cooperation with the Arkansas Traveler, this is the Sports Advantage.
And that's what happened. The first show produced outside of class.
We had to give Professor Foley all the credit because he loved the idea of anybody having new ideas and was all for it as long as, you know, we put in the work and got the help.
We'll take your calls.
All this and we'll have plenty of trivia next on the Sports Advantage. We just didn't really know what we wanted to do with it. We just knew we wanted to get up there, have fun, be two guys talking about sports, and kind of we'd figure it out as we went along the way, and it kind of just kept growing and growing from there.
And then came the first news show produced outside of class, which aired in 1999. 9 at 9 was supposed to be 9 minutes of news at 9 o'clock, but it usually lasted longer.
One day, a couple of our senior broadcast journalism majors, Ashley Spurlock, she was Ashley Rogers in those days, and Brian Thomason came to me and said, we'd like to do news on our own at UATV. So it was really their idea.
We all needed more practice. We all needed more opportunity to really hone our skills and get brushed up and really just kind of get polished so that we could be on TV with a resume tape. That's pretty much what the focus was, is what do I need to do in order to get a resume tape together? The only way we were going to get there is be able to focus more time on being able to be on TV.
I think it was just Brian and I wanting to do as much as possible that we could to get on-air experience to put our tapes together so when we graduated, you know, we could get jobs. But we were just like the diehard UATV junkies. We lived it, breathed it.
You know, Ashley and I working side by side, and we had two very different personalities. So she would tell you that this is true. We loved each other to death, and we also drove each other crazy. But it was because we both challenged each other, and we both brought out the best in each other and really made each other work really hard. We had to.
But we found out really quickly that it was very difficult to put a newscast together with such, you know, a limited staff. So that's why we did the 9 at 9, because literally even doing 9 minutes of news, that took extensive amount of time for us to go out and put the stories together. And I know that there were many evenings on last minute when we didn't have enough stuff, you know, to fill that entire 9 minute slot. So we would literally be reading the newspapers right before the, you know, the broadcast, trying to put in some readers and things like that to fill that extra space, because we, you know, we didn't have the Associated Press news feed. We didn't have any, you know, video feeds or anything to get from. What you saw on there was all completely original content that we put together.
An important part of those early shows was a creative group energy that allowed the students to create wonderful programming on their own, often with very limited resources, but also to have fun.
He is a stud.
I mean, that's just ridiculous.
We had a cutout of Corliss Williamson and a couple of team pennants. We may have had one helmet that somebody donated, and that was it. I mean, that was our set. It was limited to whatever we could find. There was no sponsors. There was no big technology, no big high-def TVs. It was nothing. It was just basic stuff.
There would be people wanting to come in and help us with our show, and, you know, they would see me in the hallways or something and say, hey, you guys are working on such and such show. Do you mind if I come and help? Like, please come and help us.
It was a team effort, and we did work really to get well together as a team. And honestly, you know, obviously we wouldn't have been able to pull this show off without everyone else participating.
It was a family. We were absolutely 100%, I think, a family. Some of these people were my best friends at the time. You know, some of my best friends for life were made from here.
It was 1 week to the next. Let's do different things. Let's bring different people in here. Let's bring a coach in here. Let's bring a different commentator in here. We had we had a former athlete from the university come in here and talk with an interview. We had an audience in here. We had all different kind of things. So throughout a semester, it probably, there was no really pattern to it, but it was just, it was us producing a show and having a lot of fun.
A few other landmarks in UATV's history have dealt with other key issues: money for further development of resources and new programming challenges. Live programming came in the form of election coverage, like this Super Tuesday show.
To the primaries, and some people,
as he said, the younger voter is very important in this election.
More money came from the efforts of both students and faculty.
It was constantly making arguments to the dean's office, making requests, arguing or making, you know, preparing rationales for why we needed this and needed that, and then finding ways to get things done when we didn't have the money.
It became the media fee after we got it changed. Before this, all the money went to the yearbook or to the newspaper. They got half and half. Well, we thought it was only right if we were going to be a true publication, you know, real news source on campus, why don't we get a third of that money? So we got on the pub board, and by the end of that semester, that first semester that we were doing it, we were getting one third of the fee. So we worked for it, we got it, and that enabled us to start getting the paid staff and being able to focus more attention.
Growth over the years has built on these early shows, and equipment and facilities have improved over time to encompass current digital technology. But students still have the freedom to create their own programs.
It was started to be a television station that would be two things. It would be an on-air laboratory for broadcast journalism, and it would be a station that would be produced and operated by the students. That's what it was in 1996, and that's what it is now. And as long as I have anything to do with it, that's the way it's always going to be. And so if I look back and I think about, well, we actually have done that here. We've built this TV station. And it is such a great sense of pride and satisfaction for me because it belongs to the students.
For UATV, this is Judy Luna.